If you like Pinot Noir, you're going to love the wine I have for you this week. It is Nerello Mascalese. And Nerello Mascalese is an indigenous grape to Sicily. In fact, it comes from not just Sicily, but it comes from the Mount Etna area. It's named after a small village at the foothills of Mount Etna. Now, Mount Etna is still an active volcano. Oh yeah. In fact, when you go to the vineyards, you're going to see this beautiful, dark, rich soil, and then you're going to see some things that look like rocks in it. Those are not rocks. Those are actually what they call lava bombs. What happens is Mount Etna will still spew out lava. It will go into the vineyards. It'll cool and make these formations that look like rocks. Wow. We just don't think about things like that, do we? There are lots of indigenous grapes to Sicily. We just don't drink enough of them to get a lot of them in our grocery store. But I found this one in Total Wine for about $15. And this is a great deal for the quality in the glass. This is from Cortese. And this is a couple that came from Northern Italy down to Sicily to make wines with indigenous grapes. And this is their Nostru line, which is their entry-level wine. And it's got several different grapes in. They have a white, Catarato, they've got this one and a couple more. And I love their labels too. Their labels are inspired by Sicilian Majolica. And oh my gosh, when you go to Sicily, the colors are fabulous, as is all the pottery. And this one actually has an agave plant on it, which grows wild all over the island. And it's a survivor and tough. And that's why the Nerello Mascalese bottle has it on there, because the Nerello Mascalese grape is just like that too. It needs a lot of differentiation between day and night temperatures. So that's why it grows so well in the Mount Etna area. So let's go ahead and taste this wine, and then we'll talk a little bit about how to serve it and what to serve it with. So first of all, let's look at the color. And just like Pinot Noir, it is a lovely ruby color, and it's not super dense in the glass. In other words, I can see through it. When I swirl and smell it, I get red fruits and cherries. I get a lot of spiciness, specifically cinnamon, and I get some dried herbs in there as well. All right, now I'm gonna taste it. Wow, it does taste exactly like it smells. When I let it run down on either side of the back of my tongue, just like Pinot Noir, it's got a good amount of acidity, which means it's gonna go well with food. So my mouth is still watering. That's the indicator of acidity. When I ran it up underneath my front lip, I had very light tannins. And that's not surprising, because remember, I compared it to Pinot Noir, that also has light tannins. I'd serve this up a little bit chilled, just like I do Pinot Noir. So I'd pop it in the fridge for 20 or 30 minutes before I served it. Now, what do we serve it with? If you're talking cheese, I love it with pecorino. I love it with an Italian cheese called Caciocavallo, which you can find in a nicer cheese department. It's kind of like Sicilian mozzarella, only I think better. And also provolone goes really well with this wine. And food, y'all, think about Sicilian food. Lots of fish. I tell you, grilled or seared salmon with a fresh tomato salsa. It's wonderful with this wine. I also like this with like eggplant parmesan, or if we're talking Sicily, eggplant pecorino, right? An eggplant dish made with pecorino instead of parmesan. And then meatballs with a little bit of an arrabbiata or spicy sauce. Or if we're going totally Sicilian, let's have it with some arancini, the rice balls that have ragu in the middle of them. I hope you find this wine, again, Total Wine, $15, worth the trip. I hope you enjoy it, and I hope that you have lots of good wine before next week and weeknight wine. I am Nancy Waldeck. I'm a healthy chef partyologist. I have a company called Taste and Savor, and I love sharing wine with all of you. Cheers.